Hi, I am Can Yesilyurt from Istanbul University. In this video, I'm going to present some of our recent works based on anomalous Hall effect in Weyl semimetals. This is the outline of the speech. First, I will try to address recent theoretical and experimental progress on anomalous Hall effect, followed by our calculations on anisotropic conductance and the main point, which is emerged transverse conductance. Then I'm gonna present several analyses such as the role of anisotropy and the role of transport angle in generating anomalous Hall signal. Finally, you will see from the numerical simulations which perfectly support our theoretical idea. In the last 2 years, a significant number of papers published in the subject of anomalous Hall effect or nonlinear Hall effect. It's well known that broken time reversal symmetry eventually leads Hall signal in semimetallic conductors. However, these experiments show that even under time reversal symmetric conditions, Hall effect and even nonlinear Hall effect can be observed. And this experiment clearly detects the angular dependence of anomalous Hall voltage. In both of the papers, authors suggest Berry curvature as the origin of the Hall voltage measure. Our motivation in this work was to find out if we can calculate the nonlinear anomalous Hall signal by using solely quantum transport. We can address the anomalous Hall effect as non-zero gauge potential in the absence of magnetic field. The origin of the Hall type signals don't have to be originate from the magnetic potential. For example, the uniaxis strain in the hexagonal lattices can cause gauge potential, which is often called pseudo-magnetic field. In one of our previous published papers shown here, we actually showed that anisotropy and electrical potential difference may cause transverse deflections and refractions with broken transverse symmetry. As you can see from the figure, the Fermi surface orientations of a junction with different potentials are very similar for anisotropic Weyl fermion under electrical potential and isotropic fermion under magnetic field. And we further investigated this effect and utilized it for Wally filter and the conductance modulation applications in these previously published studies. Also, we previously observed the effect of the anisotropy experimentally as well. This is scanning laser mapping of tungsten telluride nanoflake with circular electrode geometry like this. This experiment shows that photothermoelectric transport is highly anisotropic in tungsten telluride, and the experimental result was very consistent with our calculations based on calculated band structure shown in this figure. In all three experimental results shown in the previous slides, the material was tungsten telluride. Tungsten telluride is type 2 Weyl semimetal, and its electrical characteristic can be described with minimum two Weyl nodes in a simplest way. Therefore, the conductance profile can be calculated based on the Weyl Hamiltonian and the Landau-Butticelli equation like this. Note that the conductance profile actually means conductance versus transport angle, which is perfect circle in the regular conductor, but it's peanut shape for two-fold symmetric Weyl semimetals, as you can see from this figure. Using the conductance profile, electrical potential can be calculated at a particular point depending on the device geometry. Here the example device consists of multi-terminal circularly aligned electrodes, which is the most appropriate setup as our goal is to probe the direction dependence of the Hall signal as well. In this way, I can change the transport direction to several possibilities without changing the alignment of the source, drain and the Hall probes with respect to each other. This is one of the main results I want to show. Here in this example, transport directions are horizontal, 45 degree and vertical. If you look carefully, the potential around the points where we measure the Hall voltage are almost identical for horizontal and vertical configurations, which means zero potential difference at the Hall probes. Please note that these directions are anisotropy directions and generally close to the crystal axis. However, if the transport direction is just between these two directions, the potential around the Hall probes are different, and this means non-zero Hall signal. This shows the Hall voltage against the full angle space. The blue one is the longitudinal and the red one is the transverse voltage differences. And I can say that this calculated angular dependence of the Hall voltage is perfectly in agreement with the experimental result recently published. From this figure, you can see that. One of the important points is that the transverse voltage is directly related to the broken symmetries. For example, in isotropic Weyl Hamiltonian, Hall signal vanishes while it's getting more pronounced if material is isotropic. In the Hamiltonian, lower tilt velocity means low anisotropy in this example, and the zero tilt velocity means isotropic fermion. Apart from the analytical solutions I showed so far, recently we developed full-scale numeric simulations of potential distribution to see the effect of the electric field under near equilibrium conditions. I will run the simulation and you will see the potential distribution map and its gradient. And this is the plot of potential with increasing E field. So to analyze the distribution map, you can see the potential values at two perpendicular cross sections of the total distribution map, which give the longitudinal and transverse distributions for different electric field values. And this parameter is related to the electric field. And the longitudinal and transverse voltages shown here are measured at these four points, and they were extracted from these distributions. Well, as a result, the extracted voltage values shows that there is nonlinear relation between longitudinal and transverse voltages, and the transverse voltage is almost linearly dependent on the square of longitudinal voltage. We may explain this behavior such that the electrical field is breaking the transport symmetry, and the transverse conductance symmetry is already broken. So normally only broken transverse symmetry would cause linearly dependent Hall signal, but here we got another effect in play, and that broke the transport symmetry. So the coupling of these two broken symmetries may be the underlying reason of the nonlinearity in the Hall voltage. In all calculations and results I showed so far, we consider DC excitation and near equilibrium conditions. In our current work, which is still under preparation, AC current is considered as the excitation source in order to examine the nonlinearity and the second order Hall signal. In the simulation, you will see the potential distribution map and its gradient, and below, longitudinal and transverse voltages while system is under AC excitation. Sorry about that. So this is just one cycle of the one sine cycle finished, and this is the second one finished. But alongside of the theoretical and numerical calculations, we also aim to probe the potential distribution map experimentally as well. We produce bulk single crystals, tungsten telluride, and similar materials with chemical vapor transport method in our facility, and transfer the exfoliated layer to prefabricated devices, and such as the ones you are seeing here. These are our recently fabricated samples where the circular channel diameter is about 2 micrometer in the smallest one, and it's going up to 10 micron. In the similar experimental works with multi-terminal circular channel. The channel diameter is quite large, about the 10-20 micron. We are trying to reduce the channel length as much as possible to get better measurement. Although the mean free pad and the coherence length in tungsten detailurite are not too short. Okay, another point is that the tungsten detailurite oxidization rate is not too low. Therefore, the conducting the transfer and preparation operations of the nanoflakes in the isolated environment is crucial to be able to measure clean signal in such difficult measurements like anomalous hall. And finally, I would like to address the take-home messages. First, in Dirac and Weyl semimetals, anisotropic energy bands can be considered as one of the origin of the anomalous hall effect and its derivatives. Conductance in such materials is angle dependent and its profile is determined by the broken symmetries. Electric field is the factor that breaks the transport symmetry of the system with already broken conductance symmetry, and it's the one of the elements that give rise to the nonlinear behavior of the transverse Hall signal. Thank you very much for listening, and if you have questions or comments, you can use the conference board or send to my email address.